We all have moments during our careers when we become restless and think, I'm ready for something new, but I have no idea what the next job looks like. This can be quite daunting. Sometimes we trigger this event ourselves, while at other times, other people make the decision for us. For example, in the case of a job loss after a restructuring. But making career choices is a continuous process during our whole career, rather than just a one-time event. As we are learning and developing ourselves, we want to move on to new challenges. In addition, our work context is continuously changing around us, and we may decide at some stage that our current work environment is not right for us anymore. Career changes, therefore, can be gradual moves to a next step or a complete departure from what we are doing before. As our life expectancies go up and the work context is more dynamic than ever, we can all expect to make more career choices during our lives than our parents have ever done. I do not believe in precise career planning. As writer and cartoonist Alan Saunders has dubbed, life is what happens to you while you're busy making other plans. In his commencement address at Stanford in 2005, Steve Jobs likewise said, "You can't connect the dots looking forward, and you can only connect them looking backward." So you have to trust that the dots will somehow connect in your future. You have to trust in something, your gut, destiny, life, karma, whatever. This approach has never let me down, and it has made all the difference in my life. So does this mean that it does not make sense to have a plan at all? I believe that is still helpful to have a plan, as it gives a sense of direction in your work life, even if you don't know that it will probably never play out in the way you hoped it would. You may actually be positively surprised. We've developed a simple framework that will help you think about your next career steps.
Let us now share the framework. There are four pieces to it. The first box is your edge. This is everything that makes you special when you compare yourself to your peers. It is up to you who you want to compare yourself to. Your edge are those strengths that make you special and differentiate you from others. They make you, you. The second box is about flow. Being in flow means forgetting the world around you because you are fully absorbed by the task at hand. Flow is a joyful situation of energized focus. When you are in flow, your work feels effortless. The questions for this second box are, in which situations over the last few months have you been in flow? What's the common theme in these situations? In the second part of the course, you reflected on your passions. You may want to have a look at your workbook again, as your passions may guide you to your moments of flow. They may even coincide. The third box is about context. The key question here is, what's the context you need around you in order to be successful? The assumption here is that a context that supports our development will ultimately make us more successful. Let us reflect on this for a moment. A context that supports our development is not necessarily a pleasant context. Edgar Schein, former professor at MIT, argues that all learning is based on coercion. That is, you have to be forced to do it, and even pain, because you either have no choice, as is the case for children, or it is painful to replace something that is already there with new learning. We believe that the optimum is a pleasant work environment with significant but healthy challenges. Examples of specific questions to consider in the context box are, in what type of organizational culture do I want to work? What are my colleagues like? How much money do I want to make? How important is career growth to me? What are the opportunities for advancement? What does the work environment look like? What's the ideal location of my work? Where do I want to live? How international should the environment be? Are there opportunities to travel? What's the work-life balance like? How important is autonomy to me? With which types of stakeholders do I want to work? And last but not least, what do my loved ones, for example, my partner, children, broader family, friends, need from me in order to be happy? The fourth and final box of the framework is legacy. You have defined your legacy when putting together your personal charter in the second part of this course. Legacy is what you want to do for others.
You now have all the pieces of the framework, so perhaps you can now create a version of the framework for you. I would encourage you not to overthink this. Just make a first version. You can always change things later as you learn more about yourself.